A 45-year-old patient arrives at the emergency room following a collapse. In the heart of the emergency room, a life hangs in the balance. The clock strikes the 10th minute since a sudden, unexpected collapse has left a 45-year-old in a state of arrest. Upon arrival, the medical team is met with a daunting scene. The patient is unresponsive, a silence where the rhythm of life should beat. There's no central pulse to be felt, the blood pressure undetectable. It's a race against the clock, and every second counts. Without missing a beat, the medical team springs into action, initiating cardiopulmonary resuscitation. The chest compressions, rhythmic and firm, are a desperate plea to the silent heart, a call to action. As one hand works tirelessly against the still chest, another swiftly establishes an intravenous line, a lifeline delivering essential medications directly into the bloodstream. The patient's airway is secured with endotracheal intubation, a tube ensuring oxygen reaches the lungs, a crucial element in the intricate dance of life. Amidst the flurry of activity, continuous monitoring is set up, a vigilant eye on the ever-changing landscape of vital signs, a guide in the labyrinth of the unknown. The patient's heart rhythm presents a daunting challenge, ventricular fibrillation. The heart's electrical activity is in chaos, the ventricles quivering uselessly instead of pumping blood. The team responds promptly, delivering successive shocks in an attempt to restore normal rhythm. Amiodarone, a medication used to treat and prevent certain types of serious, life-threatening ventricular arrhythmias, is administered. Yet the heart remains stubbornly in fibrillation, refractory to the initial attempts. The option of using a double sequential defibrillator, while not pursued in this case due to hospital policy, hovers in the background. Despite ongoing CPR, despite multiple interventions, the condition persists. The team, however, remains undeterred. The commitment to save a life remains steadfast, the resolve unshaken. Within moments, the medical team is fully engaged in a life-saving effort. Their dedication, their expertise, their swift response all converge in a concerted effort to bring a heart back from the brink. The journey, however, is just beginning. The patient presents with ventricular fibrillation, a severe cardiac rhythm disturbance. This is a life-threatening condition where the heart quivers instead of pumping blood effectively. It's a race against time, and the medical team swings into action. Following the advanced cardiac life support guidelines, they deliver successive shocks to the patient's heart. This electric jolt is intended to reset the heart's rhythm, but sometimes the first shock doesn't do the trick. So they persist, administering two shocks in quick succession. Alongside the shocks, the team introduces the drug Amiodarone into the patient's system. This medication, known for its antiarrhythmic properties, is intended to restore a regular heartbeat. They administer 300 milligrams, then 150 milligrams, hoping for a positive response. But this is a stubborn case of ventricular fibrillation. Despite the team's swift and concerted efforts, the patient's heart rhythm remains erratic. The condition is refractory, resistant to treatment. This is where the team's adaptability and patience are tested. They could opt for a double sequential defibrillator, a device that delivers two shocks in quick succession from different angles. However, hospital policy does not permit this approach, so they must continue with the standard protocol, persistently trying to reset the heart's rhythm while keeping the patient stable. The medical team continues with their interventions, maintaining their composure amidst the urgency. They remain focused, constantly monitoring the patient's vital signs, adjusting their strategies based on the patient's response. This is the reality of CPR. It's not always a straightforward journey from collapse to recovery. It's a winding road with unexpected twists and turns, where the healthcare professional's adaptability, persistence, and teamwork are key. The challenge of refractory VF tests the team's adaptability and patience. It's a tough fight, but they are determined, unwavering in their commitment to save the patient's life. This is the fight against ventricular fibrillation, an intense battle where every second counts, and every action could mean the difference between life and death. At the 20-minute mark of CPR, a critical turning point emerges. The team's vigilant monitoring reveals an unexpected development during an echo investigation: pseudo-pulseless electrical activity, or pseudo PEA. This is a peculiar situation where cardiac activity is visible on the monitor and detectable in the bedside echocardiogram, but there's an absence of a central pulse. It's like the heart is performing a silent opera. It's moving, but the body isn't feeling the rhythm. This discovery of pseudo PE prompts a shift in the medical team's approach. The team realizes that they are not dealing with a simple case of ventricular fibrillation anymore. They are now faced with a complex rhythm problem that requires a more nuanced response. Sticking to their commitment to save the patient's life, the team continues with CPR. But now, they also include a regular administration of epinephrine every 4 minutes. Epinephrine, as some of you might know, is a life-saving drug used in CPR that increases coronary and cerebral blood flow, enhancing the chance of successful defibrillation. Alongside this, the team implements additional interventions. They administer normal saline to address any potential volume issues, and they introduce norepinephrine, a potent vasopressor, to help raise the patient's blood pressure. It's a delicate balancing act, adjusting the intervention strategy while maintaining the intensity of the resuscitation efforts. This episode of Pseudo PEA emphasizes the importance of continuous monitoring during resuscitation. It's a reminder that in the high-stakes world of emergency medicine, things can change in an instant, and it's not just about the initial diagnosis and response. It's about constantly reassessing the patient's condition, adapting the strategy in real time, and employing a combination of medical knowledge, experience, and instinct to guide the resuscitation. The unexpected pseudo PEA underscores the importance of real-time assessments and adjustments during resuscitation. It's a testament to the medical team's adaptability and resilience, and a poignant reminder of the complex, unpredictable nature of life-saving efforts in the emergency room. After 40 intense minutes, a very weak pulse is detected, a beacon of hope in the challenging cardiopulmonary resuscitation scenario. This is the moment where the tireless efforts of the medical team start to bear fruit. The return of spontaneous circulation, often referred to as ROSC. At this point, the patient's vital signs start to stabilize, albeit weakly. The blood pressure reads 80 over 50, heart rate at 60 beats per minute, and the patient's pupils are of normal size and reactive. These signs are a testament to the resilience of the human body and the relentless efforts of the medical team. Following the return of spontaneous circulation, the medical team's actions are swift and precise. Recognizing the potential underlying causes of the cardiac event, the team promptly consults a cardiologist. They suspect ischemic heart disease, a condition where the heart muscles don't get enough oxygen due to critical blockage in the heart's blood vessels. In no time, the patient is swiftly transported to the catheterization lab, a specialized facility equipped to diagnose and treat heart conditions. Here, a significant blockage is revealed in the patient's left anterior descending artery, or LAD, a crucial vessel responsible for supplying blood to the heart. To address this, a stent is placed in the blocked artery to keep it open, ensuring the heart muscle receives the oxygen-rich blood it desperately needs. In addition, an intra-aortic balloon pump, or IABP, is used to help the heart pump more blood, further stabilizing the patient's condition. Therapeutic hypothermia, also known as targeted temperature management, is initiated. This procedure, which involves lowering the body temperature, can protect the brain from potential damage following a cardiac arrest. The return of spontaneous circulation marks a significant victory in this challenging case. It's a testament to the power of persistent, well-coordinated efforts and quick thinking in the face of a complex medical emergency. It also serves as a reminder of the importance of continuous monitoring and adaptability in the realm of emergency medicine. This challenging case underscores the complexity of resuscitation scenarios. And as we've journeyed through this gripping case, several key takeaways have emerged, all of which highlight the importance of adaptability, continuous monitoring, and collaboration in emergency medicine. And first off, let's focus on the power of adaptability. In the ever-evolving landscape of a resuscitation scenario, the ability to pivot and adjust your approach is paramount. This was demonstrated in our case when the medical team recognized the pseudo PEA and adjusted their approach accordingly. This is a testament to the necessity of being ready to adapt your strategies in the blink of an eye. Next, we move to the significance of continuous monitoring. This case illuminates how ongoing monitoring can reveal unexpected developments, such as the pseudo PEA. Without the constant vigilance of the medical team, this critical turning point might have been missed. Therefore, let's reiterate, continuous monitoring is not just an option, it's a necessity. And then there's collaboration. The importance of collaborative efforts between medical disciplines was brought to the fore in this case. When the patient's pulse returned, the ER team promptly consulted a cardiologist, demonstrating the significance of interdisciplinary collaboration in achieving successful outcomes. Last but not least, this case has shown us the need for real-time assessments and adjustments. The pseudo PEA incident is a stark reminder that emergencies are dynamic and require swift and decisive action. It's not just about following a set protocol, it's about responding to the unique challenges of each case as they unfold. In conclusion, this case has given us valuable insights into the world of challenging cardiopulmonary resuscitation scenarios. It has reinforced the need for adaptability, continuous monitoring, collaboration, and real-time assessment in emergency medicine. In the face of challenging resuscitation scenarios, resilience, commitment, and collaboration are key to successful outcomes. And this case serves as a testament to just that. As we move forward, let's carry these lessons with us, continuing to strive for excellence in patient care.